Hello. Form 941, employer calling, federal tax return, part 3, line 17 and 18. Tell us about your business. So if a question does not apply to your business, just leave a blank. So line 17, if your business has closed or you stop paying wages, you check this box here and you enter the final date that you pay wages. In this session, I'm going to talk about transfer, business transfer or sales. So when let's take an example that you are a sole proprietor with employees. So therefore, you file Form 941 and you, in 2020, which you are filing Form 941 for the first quarter, for instance, because we put for first quarter on this one, and you switch from a sole proprietor to an LLC, for instance, the date you make that switch within this quarter that you are filing. So that's pretty much a transfer. But for the quarter within the you make that transfer from sole proprietor to LLC, you as sole proprietor and the LLC, both of you, you will file Form 941. So as a sole proprietor, you'll file Form 941 and you'll report wages that you paid before the transfer and the tax you pay before the transfer. That's what you'll put on your Form 941 for the first part and for part two. So, and the LLC will file the Form 941 for the same quarter to report wages paid by the LLC after the transfer within that quarter, and will report the taxes paid, collected, withheld, and paid by the LLC after the transfer on the Form 941. So, and as the sole proprietor, you could fill up this part 3 as well and check this box as the end of the business as a sole proprietor, because as an LLC, you might have a new identification number for the business and you will stop using the old identification number that you use as a sole proprietor. You can check that with the IRS. And because when you file with the state to become an LLC, you have to report that to IRS and request an identification number. So when you change identification number, you're not going to use the same one. I think it makes sense to just check this box to close the sole proprietor file like a final return for the sole proprietor, and you put the final date that you pay wages as a sole proprietor. And at the same time, you need to attach a document to the Form 941. And for more information on transfer, you can go to IRS instructions for Form 941, page 6, to read about it. But you'll attach a form to your return, and that form, that document will have the new name of the owner, the new name of the business. And if the business became LLC, partnership, S-corp, corporation, or a sole proprietor, you'll mention that on the document. You'll mention the dates of the transfer, or if that's a sale, you'll mention the dates. So, and you'll mention if that is a transfer or a sale. That will be mentioned on the document and the date of the change of the transfer. So the name of the person that will keep the payroll record, you know, for the old business, I will say the payroll record under the old business, where that will be the address where the record will be kept and who will be in charge of that. You'll enter that information as well. So now when we go back to our form, so line 17, if you are just closing your business, you click here and you put the last day you pay wages. So if you are a seasonal employer and you hire employees seasonally, like summer for summer job or for winter, things like that, you will check this box. That's line 18. You will check this box. So that means you are just letting IRS know that you are not going to be filing Form 941 for every single quarter, but just for the quarter that you'll have employees and you'll pay wages. So each time you file 941, you have to check this so that IRS does not expect Form 941 from you for the next quarters. And if you are not a seasonal employer, but you don't pay wages for all the quarters you are required to file 941, you have to file 941 even if wages to employees is zero and tax withheld is zero. You have to file it. And if you want to request from IRS to switch from 941 to Form 944, which is annual federal employer, annual federal tax return, because you don't pay wages for every single quarter, you can call IRS at 800-829-4933. I repeat, 800-829-4933. You can call IRS using that number to request their approval to switch from Form 941 quality filing to Form 944 annual filing, but you have to wait for their approval in the mail before you switch. Until then, you have to keep filing Form 941 every single quarter, even if you have zero wages and zero tax. In my instance, for example, for my LLC, at one point, I was at the beginning, IRS requested Form 944. And when I filed it, they sent me an email saying that based on my record with them, I was required to file 941. And then I filed it for a quarter, and they sent me mails for all the situations, and they sent me a mail stating that based on my record, I was required to file 944. So for the years that I didn't have any income generated and I'm the only employee of the business, I didn't have any wages or any tasks withheld, but still, when they said I need to file 941, I filed it. When they say I need to file 944, just one time of the year, I filed it as well with zero numbers. So just those places just stay blank, but you have to file it whether you have a task to report or not. So that's pretty much what we want to cover in this session. Part 3 of Form 941, Employer Quality Federal Tax Return. Thank you for watching. I'm Afiavi Ojune Liberman, creators of Liberman Consulting LLC YouTube channel and owners of Nina Soap. And our website is ninasoap.com.